resources. Everyone. Only few people. I wanted to hear only from 4 or 5 resources, 5 people. How many of you think those who are working, you are not being paid enough of compared to your efforts? Of what are the efforts that you are keeping in your organization where you're working, you're not being paid enough? How many of you feel like this? Just quickly, one person offline, anyone else offline? You feel like you are being paid enough of what your efforts you are keeping? Okay, one person offline who is feeling like he's not being paid enough of his efforts that he's spending. And online, how many of you are there? Just unmute once and say your name, that's fair enough. Okay, or you can, Manish, I'll come to you. Manish, who else? And what is your name? Anish. Anish and Manish. Next. Who is next? Vasanti. Who else? Okay, 3 resources. That is fair enough. Anish, why you feel like you are not being paid enough? No, I'm not asking about your satisfaction level, but I'm asking straightforward, why you feel you're not being paid enough by your organization? You got it or you will be getting it? You are not, you cannot say that. By keeping the same efforts in other organization, definitely I'll be getting more amount of money than what I'm getting currently being paid by my current organization. You cannot say this. Future you cannot expect, and any other organization you cannot expect. Any other reason? That's it. Manish, you agree with me or not? No. If you are going to change your job, your salary will be increased for sure. You cannot say that you are going to put the same efforts in future organization. You cannot say that. Now you partially agree or 100% agree? It's not about the money that you're going to get as a hike. Are you sure 100% that you're going to work the same? Are you going to deliver the same artifacts what you're delivering by putting the same efforts? Or the company may expect you to keep more efforts than what you had kept. They don't bother about what efforts you had kept in the previous organization. They bother about what you're going to keep currently in the current organization. That can be more than the previous organization. You agree or not? Next, online, Manish, why you feel like you are not being paid enough?
They want us to take more responsibilities.
They want you to take more responsibilities than what you wanted to serve, right?
Then what we are doing right now, they expect
you are taking more responsibilities than what you are paying. That is what your perception, because you're that's why you feel like you are being paid less. Next.
Yeah. I mean, yes, that is the one which stops us from getting promotions.
Okay, it is with respect to the efforts that you're keeping by time that you're spending in your organization. Actually, it is morning 11 o'clock to 8 o'clock, let's say, for example. 11 o'clock to 8 o'clock, but you're spending like 11 o'clock to 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, but you're being paid still same salary. Now you're not satisfied. Next.
What I think is I could not take other people into confidence, and I'm not able to progress in my career.
You are being taken other people into consideration. Comparison is there. That's what you're saying.
Yes, I feel like the same job.
So you and your colleague are there. Your organization is comparing you with your colleague and it's not paying. For example, let me clarify this. Correct me if I'm wrong. You have to work from 11 o'clock to 8 o'clock. You're working actually. You're delivering whatever that is being assigned to you. There is someone else in your organization, your colleague, who is working from 8 o'clock to 12 o'clock. They are also delivering the same. Now the comparison comes into picture. You feel like we both are producing the same results, but I'm working the time that is being actually meant for. Meant how long I have to spend? 9 hours I'm spending. I am not staying back till 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock. Someone else is doing the same work, but they're spending till 11 o'clock to 12 o'clock. They're getting promotions, let's say, for example. Comparing with them, business is not giving me hikes, not paying me what they have to pay. This is what you wanted to say, right? I'll come to this point later again. Next, someone else called Vanita or someone. I want to hear from you. Vasanti, what is that?
Yeah, sir, as you said, with comparison only we feel so that we are paid less. We work more, but we are paid less.
Then why don't you compete? Why you take it like a comparison? Why you don't take it like a competition? Why don't you compete? Same, you think other way around. Why don't you take it as a competition? Why you are comparing? Why you feel like business is comparing? Where you do not want to lose yourself, right? You feel like I'm going to lose myself, my family and all, spending more time there. That is true actually. Okay. So now you feel like your organization is paying less than what is the effort that you're keeping. So what is your next action? Did you say this anytime to your managers? Did you say this? Did you raise your voice anytime expressing yourself to your organization, higher authorities? Why?
Yeah, sir.
Okay, when you set them, what is their reply? If you say yes, what is their reply?
They'll say that it is all circumstances and situations that have happened.
Depends on the situations.
Favoring them or something.
No, when you are being given with offer letter, it's by your performance, it's by your divisional performance, it's by your team performance, it's by your division performance, it's by your overall organization performance, it's your countrywide business performance, overall worldwide organization performance. All that is going to impact your packages. It's not you. It's not only you, and your efforts will not be taken into consideration. See, the point here is, when you are not satisfied of what you are being paid for, what you are being paid with by your organizations, this is negative thinking. Now, the impact will be only on you. That is the first thing, the primary person, the primary object which is going to be affected is you. Your career will not move to the next level for sure. I'm not saying that you should not have desire. You should have desire of earning more. That is most important. If you have that real desire of earning more, the way how you are keeping efforts in your organization will be definitely different. You have desire of earning more money by not keeping more efforts. That is the desire. This is negativity. It might be with intention, with your knowledge, or might be without your knowledge, because you don't know that. So you are just getting into a negative way. See, your organization is giving you more responsibility to take. So you're taking the more responsibilities. You feel like I'm taking more responsibilities, but I'm not being paid enough. How can you say that you're taking more responsibility? That is what the actual responsibility that you have to take that your organization is giving. How can you say? Where is it written that it is more responsibility than your job? See, when you are being given offer letter, you have to work on this. Depending on the circumstances, you will be given with additional work. Depending on the circumstances, you have to stretch work, stretch yourself working on the project or the task that are being assigned with. Depending on the situations, you have to take additional responsibility based on the client requirement and service this organization. This is what you have signed for. We do not read all these things. But now, if you are a business, you will come to know the pain of the business. If you are an employee, you will not come to know about all these things. If you are a business, you will come to know the pain of the organizations. I am not supporting organizations and saying that you are wrong. See, it's all about your thinking and your perception, how you act to the situation. Whether you take it into a positive way or whether you take it into a negative way is going to impact you and your career growth in your life. See, you take it as a competition and you do work here, or you keep the same efforts or more efforts in other organization, no problem. If you feel like, okay, this won't work for us at all here, what you have to do? You have to switch your organization for sure. If you are really capable of doing the things, you will not wait even for 1 minute. So your incapability speaks. It's not you. Your incapability speaks like this. You are not being paid enough. If you're really capable of doing things, will you be staying back in the same organization? The moment you feel like I am not being paid enough, you will be having, you will be holding offer from other organizations. The reason why you are not moving, it is again your fault. It's not your organization's fault. When you join in your organization as a fresher or maybe the day one, you start working with a lot of enthusiasm. Few days have move on. Okay. So as you move on, so initial way of learning will be you're learning something new. You will be happy and you wanted to serve. You do not even find the time that you're spending. Can someone please mute? So you do not even feel that you are spending the time because you are learning something. Now what happens, you know, after 1 year, maybe after 1.5 years, your learning in the project comes to an end, means it is settled actually. Now you know every issue, every change that you have to make in the, any requirement that comes, you know where to change. Any issue that comes, you know how to fix after 1.5 years. Now your learning has been stopped. Okay. So the moment your learning has been stopped, your earnings also will be stopped automatically. Okay. Now what you do is, as your we do not feel like our learning has been stopped, but we feel like everything I know everything in current project. Anything comes, previously I used to spend 1 hour, 2 hours, now I can do it in 10 minutes. Now I'm in a settled position. I'm earning money with less efforts than what I had kept initially. This is what happens with everyone, irrespective of IT industry or any other industry. Now, after a few days, what happens, you know, first initial days after 1.5 years where you know everything about what the work, what you are doing, you can quickly do it, what you had previously done for 2 hours. So till next 1 year, you will be more happier than initial days. Because with less efforts, you are making the same amount of money there where you have been given with little hike also. Now you had spent 3 years. Now when you go and ask your manager, next level of hike will not be there for this year for sure. This might have been happened to many people. Okay, now you will see less growth in your career when you compare by money. So money is the one. Now you see your growth yourself comparing your efforts that you are keeping with the income that you are, with the salary that you are being paid for. Now you have reached almost 6 lakhs per year, sorry. So after 3 years, your company has stopped giving hikes. Previously you got good hike where you are happy and all. Now it has stopped giving hikes for the people who are been here for long term without doing anything. Remember, I'm saying again, without doing anything. It means if you're going to complete a task which has been assigned to you, it doesn't mean that you're doing something for your organization. Anyone can do it. Your efforts will be calculated where you're going to keep extra efforts, which is going to add value to the organization by your own knowledge. Have you ever given any suggestion to your organization to improve the process in your organization, to your client or your current organization? For that, the organization are conducting special sessions, but there are many people who will not go to the sessions. Our focus will be always on what you are currently working, what has been assigned to me, that has been completed or not. Previously I used to take 4 hours, now I am spending only 10 to 15 minutes, I am completing. I have been improved, you feel like. You are not improved. You are where you are. Exactly, you are where you are, I'm sorry. Previously, what is that you are completing in 2 hours, if you do it now in 10 minutes, that means you have a lot of time in your hand to enhance your knowledge. You are sitting idle without enhancing your knowledge. You are expecting your organization to pay more money than what efforts you are keeping. You are a developer, you are being asked to take some other responsibility. That means your organization is giving you chance to learn business in different ways, to enhance your knowledge in different ways, which you can utilize for yourself again. Now, working on one aspect, only in one specific module, will give you only limited knowledge. You go out and I'm working on only one module. Okay, opportunities of getting the job and high with high will be less. Your organization has given now more chance to you. So where your responsibility is not only development, some other tasks where you are going to spend your time and execute it and produce the best results for your organization. Now when you go out, apart from what is your mainstream of work, you will also mention the other aspects. So that is the value that will be added to your profile, not the actual core component. Your core component is a mandatory thing. The other aspects where you had kept your focus and where you have gained more knowledge, process wise or technically or anything else, that is going to add value to your profile for sure. So your organization is giving you the additional income or additional payment as a knowledge that you're going to acquire, where you're going to expand or where you are going to put your efforts on different things or different modules other than what you have to actually work. So your organization is, it will not pay you only always by currency notes. You have to understand that if you see your income or if you see your salary as a currency note, you can never grow in your life. Your salary is not a currency note. Your salary is always the opportunities that you have, the opportunities that you are being provided with to enhance your knowledge that will be useful for your career growth and next level to your organization's growth. Your organization will always think what they think, you know. For every employee, they feel the same way. They are paying more than the efforts that the employees are keeping. Organization will feel the same way. If they're giving you 3 lakhs, they feel like we are paying more than his efforts. But as an employee, what we feel, you know, we are being paid less than what is our efforts. But organizations are not going to think about your payment as a currency note. They think about the output, what they are getting from you. They think about the business. What is the value added to the business by this resource? Any value added, pay him whatever that you want. You have made any process change in your organization that has increased the revenue of organization other than what you are being assigned with? Remember, the task which organization has come to you and they tell you that this is what you have to complete so and so time. If you have completed that and given back to organization, doesn't mean that you are serving the organization. You have to always exceed the expectations of organizations from small level to large scale industry. Any industry, it can be a smaller one or it can be large scale industry. See, let me tell you a simple story. Difference between a man and animals. Let's take a donkey. So I'm a washerman. Okay, I used to take my clothes, the clothes which I have collected for washing, to some lake every day. So carrying all this will be done by my donkey. So I'm going to keep all these clothes on his shoulders and he is going to take it to the lake every day. You do it from day one. So the years are passing. Is it going to advise you something? But you are getting more business actually. So as days are passing, you're getting more business. Means previously used to collect the clothes from 10 families, say for example. Now it is increasing day by day. So as your efforts are good, you're doing your job best. Everyone feels like, okay, if we give to him, he's going to do it best job and return to us. So the results are good. Now every day people are giving you, so the number is increasing. You're going to increase the burden on your donkey, on my donkey, sorry. Okay, what happens one day? What happens one day? So it cannot carry it. So it will move on. It will run away from your place. Okay, so now it cannot advise you for the growth. Now you cannot think yourself what to do best in order to get all the business being done with the same animal what I have today. Your expectation is, why this cannot take it forward? Because it is a donkey animal, it cannot advise you anything. Let's say you have hired a human for the same task, for example. He is an intelligent guy. I expect everyone intelligent to be there in my work. He is an intelligent guy, for example. Now, starting initially, okay, he is carrying on his shoulders everything, whatever that you have given, he is your assistant. So 10 families, 50 families also he is able to bear. 100 families now. All these clothes, he wanted to take it on his shoulders. Now, what are the two actions, either of those he can take? What he is going to do? Suppose if it is you, what you will do? I'm not comparing you with the other animal. So now it is human. It is you. A donkey is me, actually. Now you tell me, what you're going to do? You can go ahead and hire, you buy a push cart. Your efforts, my efforts will be reduced. Your efforts will be reduced. And taking it to the lake and coming back, everything will be easy. Again, after I come back, I am, see, you will take me to the lake and you will, and from the, to take the cloth to lake and come back from there. You will use me only for these two directions. While you take your dresses, the cloth, to actual customer, are you going to use me? If you use me, what happens as a donkey? What happens? When you go to actual business, you're going to showcase your employee. You're going to showcase only the output. You're going to take this cloths which are being washed. You are taking by yourself to the actual business and you're presenting there, right? Now, my efforts are increased actually. When the cloths are increasing, your effort is also increased, right? So you cannot take 100 families washed cloths to actual customer. So it is being difficult for me. Actually, it is being difficult for you. If you are a human, now you are going to guide your owner with your intelligence. You are just buy a push cart. We have some amount of money, right, that we have saved. Buy a push cart. Just give it to me. Put all your cloths there. I am going to push it. Take it forward. My efforts are reduced. What about your efforts? Obviously, your efforts are reduced. Business has increased. So this is the idea that I am giving. Actually, my business owner, have you given the same type of idea to your business anytime? Now, my business owner will be happy. Apart from the his expenditure of investment is increased, but lifetime revenue is increased. Is he going to award me or not for the idea that I have given? Definitely, you will be awarded. It's not for your physical efforts. It's not for the time you're spending. It's for your intelligence. It's always for your intelligence, you will be awarded. If you feel like you're spending more hours in your organization, that you are being paid less. You have to spend 9 hours, you are spending 12 hours of time in your organization, that you are being paid less. That means your perception, your thinking is wrong. Your business will not think the same way what you're thinking. Your business always expects you to put your efforts in such a way that it will be your intelligence that adds value to your business, that is going to improve your business as well as improve yourself or the employee. This is how your thinking has to be changed when you think about your salary that is being paid with. Now you tell me, how many of you still really feel like you are being paid less than what you are efforts are? Did we ever think like this? You will think like this if you are a business owner. So if you feel like you are working as an employee for an organization, you can never produce desired results what organization is expecting, for sure. That means you are lagging. You have to take the responsibility, feel like a business owner. You give your ideas to the actual owner. If you give 100 ideas, definitely one will be executed one day for sure. You will be rewarded. You will be rewarded like anything exceeding your expectations by your organization. Now, It's not 30%, 50% hike. You will be rewarded with hike more than what you are expecting. You will be rewarded with a car that is especially meant for you, and you will be rewarded with giving a luxurious house for your staying, for your family and everyone. This is how organizations are going to award you. Aren't there any people? You will be given with shares. So they'll be sharing stock market for you in the same organization. That will be given to you every year as an remuneration. So this is all because, not because of the physical efforts that you are keeping, not because of the time that you are spending. It is because of the ideas that you are giving to the organization where the business is increasing day by day, where the business is running so smooth compared to the previous days. The revenue is increasing, business is going so smooth. You have to think about improvement of business process. So are you taking the responsibility of ownership? If you take the responsibility of ownership, you will never feel the burden. You are feeling burden of working there means you are not taking responsibility of ownership. So every fault is with us, not with organizations. The other way around, you feel still nothing is working out, you will just move on if you are really capable. As we are incapable of doing the things, we will always blame our organizations. This is happening with everyone. If you are really capable of doing the things, you move on. You move on yourself, be an entrepreneur. You don't have that capability. I don't have that capability, I'm sorry. And I'm blaming my organization. This is wrong. So always I have to think about improving myself. So I have to get good ideas. I have to be creative. I always have to feel I have to exceed the expectations of organizations. Now you will be automatically rewarded. You are not required to ask. You're not required to go sit and in front of your manager and ask for a hike. No need. They will come to you. They will search for you. The CEO is going to ask, who is that guy? Reward him like this. So your recognition, definitely you will get the recognition what you have to get based on the efforts you are keeping, not based on the time that you are spending in your organizations. If you calculate it by currency notes, if you look at it as a currency note, if you calculate it by the time, if you feel it like a burden without, so it's not burden, it's your responsibility. You feel like responsibility, it will be done for sure. So our thinking should change, our views should change, our perception should change towards everything, not only one thing, towards your job, towards your society and everything else. This is how you have to change. If I ask you to calculate your salary, how many of you have calculated like this before? The way I've told now, how many of you have calculated like this before? Genuinely, one person is there, you just said, no problem. You know it, Himabindu, that's good. This is how you calculate. Then your career growth is in your hands. You have to put your efforts. If you have to put your efforts, you have to feel the responsibility. You have to love what you are doing. Otherwise, you cannot do. You should be passionate about what you are doing. Otherwise, it is someone else's business. You are an employee or your own business. You cannot execute it. That is for sure. Organizations exactly know actually what you have to be paid with. Let me tell you a small story. You just go ahead and come back. What is the time now? 10:30. Yeah? When did we start? Okay, let me complete this. See, I'm not saying you need to stretch efforts, right? Did I say that? You cannot stretch efforts because of your family reasons. You have to be more creative. You have to find a solution. The same work I should be able to do within the same 9 hours, being creative. That's what I told. I am not asking my assistant to carry the clothes of 10 families, 20 families, 100 families. I'm asking you, you find a solution for this. Your efforts are, I'm giving you, my expectation is work should be done. So you have to stretch more hours or something. Okay. But you find a creative, you be creative, you find a way where it can be done in 9 hours, same 9 hours. This is what my expectation actually. See, if you think, because there are successful people think like this, we have these many inventions in the world. I do not want to travel miles and miles just by walking and running. In ancient days, anything you wanted to travel, you have to walk. Later, there is a cart. There's an animal and there is a cart. Later, again, you feel like it is a burden. Now, the new invention. We have got automobile. So the efforts can be reduced by your creative thoughts, not by spending more time. You feel like if you have to spend more time, you have to come up with a solution where the same can be done in less time. This is how you have to think. It's not that you spend more time and do the same way. That will not help you. That will not help organization also. You feel like you are spending more time and doing extra work or doing executing extra tasks to business. That's wrong. So if your thinking is, if your views are changed, like if your views are going to change like this, definitely your career will be changed for sure. You will be successful in your career for sure. This is how we have to think. This is how we have to take the responsibility. Okay. So suppose you are going to leave this job, you go to next organization, your salary will be increased. Okay, sure, for sure. Are you sure that you are not going to work? So the other organization also not going to give the same work, same number of hours that you have to spend. You're not very much sure. You cannot say that. So changing the organization will not solve your problem. It may get little more money added in your account, but it will not solve your problem. Being creative, self-thinking is most important. It's you have to do by yourself. No one is going to help you in situations like this. So you have to feel it like your own responsibility. Let me ask you one question towards your perception. So tell me genuinely, whatever that you wanted to say, online resources, you just give a message on GoToMeeting with your answer. Quickly, you should not see others' answer and copy the same. Quickly, in next 1 minute, offline resource, you just go and tell me. If I ask you something like businessman, what comes into your mind immediately? Persistent, next. Helping, sir. Is that really comes to your mind? Are you saying now in motivational session? What comes to most people mind? Someone tell me. If I say businessman, money. 99.9%. I'll write on bond paper. Money. Now I want 3 or 4 people to define what is a businessman. Define in your perception, as you told, helping something, right? Define businessman. So someone is saying money, someone is saying helping others, someone is staying dedicated, that's good. Those who have this thought of money are not required to define. So someone told online, dedicated, right? Responsibility, helping others. Bhavani, what is, okay, if you have attended last week, ignore it. Tell me if you have not attended. What is the definition? How would you define a business? Those who have not attended last week's session. See, this is not, there is nothing right or wrong. It is just to know how we think about the things. What is our views? What is our perception?
No.
Helping others means how? By creating jobs. Creative, hardworking. You have to define a businessman, give a definition. He has told something by helping others, setting up an organization, and by helping others, giving jobs and all. That is what a businessman, that's good definition.
No, there is, Harsha.
Yes, please.
Some requirement is there where people need answer for that or solution for that, and they are not able to do, and a person who wants to give solution to that problem or the requirement, at the same time he wants to earn money. That is what a business.
Yes, I got it. Business man or a person who take care of earning own money on his creative and hard work, Vasanthi told. And Himabindu, what she has told is others work. It's not you. Himabindu, what you have told is by taking the responsibility on other works, he is going to execute it and he is going to earn money.
And definitely it has to, he has to earn money. Otherwise, there is no meaning between a service and
money is going to come as a secondary source. Secondary. It's like a byproduct of your work. Money will come anyway, no matter about it. Okay. See, generally our thinking and our perception, businessman, money. Money is not the first target or the first result for him. So it's a byproduct actually, money. Money will come automatically. See, businessman, in my own views, as she told, is the one. Yes, please. You want to say something?
It's an outcome actually. Money
it's
is
not
the
ultimate outcome.
Yeah, it's a
byproduct. Actual result is something different. Actual result is the desired output, what is required for that work. That is actual output. That is what people want. If you are not giving that, are you going to get the money? Still, you are a businessman. You're not giving the quality output, you will not get the money what you have to get actually. So money is the secondary one. The output we consider it as a primary. Automatically you are getting the money. Yes, go ahead, Himabindu.
That is what a difference between a service and a businessman will do. I mean, in the service, you don't expect outcome as money alone. So, requirement
is individual. In a service, you do execute something, you will not expect money. That is an individual's need actually. Okay. What we call it as, that is depends on individual, that depends on businessman. He expects money, okay. At the same time, he has to produce desired output. Towards it, he is going to work for the same. Right? So money, see, if he is not producing the desired results, money will not come. Obviously, someone is providing a service. So when you say service, business is also a kind of service where an individual has expectation of money. Other kind of social service where individual do not have expectation of money. It depends on the person. So leave about money completely. Money will come or will not come automatically. It depends on what is the output that you produce. But how you wanted to define a businessman other than using the word money, if I say, money will come as a secondary source. So that is what actually I'm looking for. Generally, if we say businessman, money is the word that we use. Money will come automatically. That's, you can put that last in the definition. See, businessman actually is the one, in my views, who understands the needs of others, who feels like that is his need. And he is going to find a solution for the need. Now tell me, in the definition, who understands others' need and find a solution, but he is not going to feel like that it is need. Can he produce the results? Is it possible? It is others' need that I wanted to find out a solution. I don't feel it like it is not, it is my need. Then what is being lost here? What is being lost? Interest, other words, responsibility is being lost. So businessman, when he is going to find a solution for your need, first he has to think about that is my need, my responsibility. Then I can put 100% efforts and do it. You wanted to start a restaurant. Okay. See, where you are selling food, right? You feel like I am going to sell this to others. I am not going to eat it. I am not going to have this. I don't bother about the taste and all. Okay. I'll prepare somehow and I'm going to sell it. First day you sell it. New hotel. As the days pass on, what happens? You have to eat your own dirty food. Right? It's not being, if you don't feel the responsibility, this is what I have to eat every day. This should be tasteful. This is for myself. I should be 100% satisfied with what I have done here. Then people will buy. Otherwise, This is what the difference between successful people and unsuccessful. They don't have responsibility. They have everything in place. Money is given, everything has been given. You have all the need, all the actual sources, what you wanted to start, what is needed to start a business. Everything is given. Can you be successful? Can you say that I will be successful for sure? But someone who can tell, say that I am going to be successful for sure, those who feel the responsibility towards what they're going to do, towards what they're doing, and they will be passionate about it. If you take the responsibility, definitely you'll be passionate about towards what you're doing. Where there is no responsibility, you cannot do anything. The same has been happening in our jobs also. In what we are doing, it's not only jobs. You are learning something, you're at your college, you don't feel responsible towards what you're doing. That's why you cannot produce best results. If you're working as an employee in any organization, generally we do not feel it like our business. We feel it like someone else's business. This comes into picture clearly, you believe or not, at the coffee machine. Simply at the coffee machine and also on the chair where you sit. I'll tell you the difference. See, the chair which I am going to use, which has been given to me by my organization, if it is a little damaged, it is a costly chair, of course. It is little damaged, immediately I am going to call someone. That is the department who is going to manage the finance and this appliances here. Okay, this is damaged. Can you please replace it immediately? They will replace it immediately. Okay, where the business, let's say it is 3,000 rupees. It will be more than that, I believe, in your organizations, for sure. Now they have to again replace it, additional 3,000 rupees. 3,000 rupees is gone. Same chair with the same damage is there in your home. Now, are you going to replace it immediately? Everyone, are you going to replace it immediately? Why? You know the value of money. You know the value of money when it is your own chair. But it is someone else's chair. Same happens at coffee machine also. We'll take coffee, we'll just have one sip. It's not good, throw it in the dustbin. It is something little happened that day. Okay, maybe some products mixture is not exactly, not in the same ratio. We'll keep it in the dustbin, we'll call it is not good. They have to replace it immediately. But in your home, if you make it by yourself, of course it is not good, taste is not good, what you will do? For now, we'll finish it. We do not want to waste it because it is our money. At the other place, it is not our money. This is the difference between people who are successful, who are not successful. Successful people in their life, they feel everything is their money, their own responsibility, and they are passionate about what they are doing. Same chair in your home, the same way it is damaged, you use it forever, you mend it, you repair it, and use it. Same way, why you are not doing? Because you feel it like someone else's money. You're ready to waste it. If you have that responsibility towards your organization, you will not go out and order for the new chair. You will just try to adjust on the same. See, if it is not completely not possible, it's a different case. In your home also, you'll replace. But for little damage also, we'll ask for replacement of many things. But in our home, we'll sit, we'll repair by ourselves, we'll spend time. Because we love it, because we have our hard-earned money is being spent here. But there also, that is your money only, that you should know. That has been bought by your money only. See, if your money is being saved here, your organization's overall performance savings will increase. As the savings increase, profit ratio will increase. So profit, how it will be? So it is based on the expenditure, what they are going to do, everything on every different resource. Now everyone is going to save money in some way. Have you ever advised your organization like that, say, to save money, something like this? In any aspect, anywhere, in any utilities or anywhere. This is not required here. Actually, our organization is wasting this money. by keeping this like this here. It is actually not required. People are not using it. You can reduce it. So you feel like this is not our work. This is the work of someone else. Have you ever drafted an email like this? Have you ever taken initiation like this? Is where your efforts, it's not only technology, application development and all, every aspect will be considered. In every aspect, it shows your knowledge, your improvement is going to be reason for your career growth. You will be paid more. We want someone as an organization. As an organization, I want someone who can improve my business, not by only application development, not by only doing the task what he is meant for. Take all responsibilities, whatever you can take. Okay, whether it has been assigned to you or not been assigned to you. Take it as your own responsibility, take the ownership. This is the meaning of ownership. This is what the difference between a person who is a businessman, who is not a businessman. Who is a successful person, who is not successful. We don't feel the responsibility. All this adds value to your career only. Obviously, there are many people in a Microsoft organization. Why CEO is only Satya Nadella? Why not Bill Gates' son? He is responsible person in the organization in all aspects. Not only taking Windows forward, Windows operating system forward, every product in Windows, every other aspects, financially, management-wise, in every other aspect, he is the best person. That's what Microsoft thinks. That's why he has become CEO. He came from ordinary family only, right? I'm not pretty much sure whether he belongs to poor family or not. At least ordinary family compared to the position what he has got today, right? He achieved. He is successful because he knows the responsibility. He's feeling that responsibility towards his organization. That is where we are missing actually. So in everything, when you go outside society, so the government property, we don't feel it like our responsibility. We don't feel it like our property. If you feel like government property is also your property, you do not damage it. Damaging government property, ultimately who is being affected? Ourselves are being affected. So this is the difference. This is what I want to tell you. This is the difference between a person who is successful. A person who is successful will never blame anyone. Any system he will never blame is not going to blame any individual. Generally, we are the people who blame politicians, ignoring our work. What we have to do, we will not bother about. But we'll throw stones on someone who is not doing well, is being corrupted. Are you doing your job perfectly? First, we have to think about that. See, blaming someone else is going to impact the same person who is blaming, not the other person. Will not be impacted always. Only you will be impacted forever, for sure. Criticizing someone also the same thing. You complain on someone also same thing. So instead of complaining, you do it by yourself. Instead of you say that there is a politician who is corrupted. Okay. You keep on blaming this with everyone else. Okay. But instead of that, why don't you try to achieve that position and be successful and be good? Because you don't know the circumstances of the other person who is playing actually on the pitch. You don't know on what circumstances he is playing like that. For outsiders, it will be easy. It is easy to blame. You don't know actually the circumstance of other person. There will be n number of sources that are acting on them. But we don't know. We don't know that. We don't bother about it actually. Simply we'll blame. Why don't you get onto the pitch and do it? It's not my responsibility. It's not my job. Everything is your job. But it needs time. You take time, you gain the ownership, and you do play, and then showcase that you have done best. Now you blame other person. That is okay. But if you are really thinking like this, you never blame others. You think about what job you have to do. Your job you have to do best. That's what you think about. Always. This is the difference between people who are successful and who are not being successful. This is how their perception, their thinking, their views are different than anyone else. See, let me tell you a story. See, as I have told you, let me come back to where I have stopped previously and little deviated. Now, your being definitely awarded with what you have to be. Let me tell you a small story. See, let's consider this is olden days, not today, where there is no money, where people used to work for food. Okay, you are going to put your efforts, so you are going to spend your efforts and you work for someone in their field or somewhere, they're going to give you some grains or something. Okay, so you take it to your home, okay, and you cook it for the day, it is done. Again, day starts, you keep your efforts, where the exchange of products was happening, let's say those days. Okay, so there was a worker. Okay, so how they are going to sell themselves today also, you'll see early morning. So people who are working like the workers who will work in construction field, they'll come on the road every day morning 7 o'clock. Those people will be picked from there and hired for day work. After day work is completed, they'll be paid with money, they will go back. Next day, same person might not be giving the work, they will come to the same place, gather in the morning. So there will be other people who are going to pick them and give them work and then give them money at the end of the day. This is what the same thing that is going to happen that we see regularly in our day to day today also. But it's not money, it's about the simply the product that you're going to use, like it's like a grains or something that you're going to use for cooking and all. Okay, exchange of products. Now those days there was a worker who used to go to every day the same place early in the morning and stand there along with everyone else. Okay, someone else is going to come down and then hire him for some work on that day and then pick him. Work is completed, they're going to give him something, so he will take it to home. Okay, today, so they will use it for tomorrow. Okay, so if they are not going to get the work one day, for day after tomorrow there will be nothing. Okay, their survival is day to day. So this is happening every day. This guy is getting something like this. Okay, it's going on. See, there was a rich man who has acres of lands, okay, who has good house, luxurious house. So this rich man was watching this guy keenly every day. See, when someone is going to take him, okay, he's working there, and this guy is day by day is getting good reputation in the market, that he's going to, if you're going to assign some task to him, the output of the task will be best than your expectation. So this guy is observing, this rich man is observing the other guy and his efforts, and day by day he is getting good comments in the society. So people are everyday people are just there, people are in queue to take him. Whoever comes first, immediately they're going to pick him for their work. That is happening. This guy is also happy of what people are giving him as a return. Okay, fine, it is going on. So one day suddenly there is no one to take him. Okay, there is no one to assign work to him. Actually, it has happened somehow. Okay, so it is already afternoon, he is not being hired. So now he feel like, okay, today there is no one is going to hire me for sure. Okay, so for tomorrow only I have something in my home, day after tomorrow again it will be a trouble. Okay, for today only there is something not available for future. If he is going to be hired today, he's going to get something that will be good for his survival if it regularly happens. But what happened is no one has hired him for today. So now this rich man is seeing him, he's so depressed today. Okay, now he had come to him and asked him, okay, we have some work in my home. Okay, you just go ahead and work in the fields. Okay, he has been hired, he went there, he has been assigned with some garden work. Okay, he has completed it. The task he has completed, he exceeded the expectations to clean the garden and all, to water the plants, to clean the garden. He actually exceeded the expectations of the rich man. He also feels the same, as everyone is saying you are doing best and all, he also feels the same. Okay, I've done best today. He is a rich man, he is a known rich man to everyone. Okay, as he is a rich man, he is going to give me something which exceeds my expectations actually. Okay, so he came that, okay, I have done the work that you have assigned to me. Okay, so I wanted to leave now. So this rich man went inside home to bring something to give him. He came back and he has given him. After the worker, this guy, once he has seen what he's been given with, he's so much depressed and asked him, I have done whatever that you have told me. I have done it in a best way. I am expecting something more than what you have given. But why you have given this to me? The rich man has replied, how many hours you work if someone is going to hire you? Morning they are going to hire you, till evening you are going to work and you get something. But you have worked only here half a day. Okay, you have worked here only half a day. This is fair enough for half a day. What he has given actually? Now he has replied, the thing what you have given me, it is not been useful for me to, it is not been useful even for cooking. What he has given is, he has given a pumpkin. So pumpkin, it is not a fresh one actually, which is a dried one. So you cannot even use it for cooking at all. So this is what sufficient for the efforts that you have kept. I am giving you what I have to give you. Just get out of here. He has taken that. He went to home. He is very much depressed. So once he is there at his home, before he went inside home itself, he has thrown that pumpkin just beside his house. He forgot it actually. Okay. Days have passed actually. Few days have been passed. Okay. After a few days, his wife has recognized there is a small pumpkin plant, little plant. Okay. He started planting that. Okay. She started. After a few days, it is growing. And after a few days, as the days pass on, this guy is still working and coming to home, and then survival as usual going on. That day, he was not impressed by the rich man. Okay. So he has got a bad opinion about the rich man even. He is the richest man. Okay. So, but he is not good. Okay. Okay. So as the days pass on, so the plant, it started blossoming. And now he got little pumpkins to that. This fellow even didn't imagine it has given hundreds of pumpkins. It is now everywhere on his house. It is everywhere on his land. And it has given hundreds of pumpkins. Now he started selling the pumpkins. He got an idea, okay, I wanted to sell this. Every day he's picking pumpkins, 25 or 30. Every day he's selling. So finally the last day. So once this plant is age is done, the last few pumpkins, he did not sell it actually. He had kept it aside to get it dried. And so that he can get that pumpkin seeds, again he is going to plant it. And he got more money than what he used to get when he is working under someone. Now he had become a businessman. He is being rich now. So one day after he has become rich, at the same place, he established a new shop or something. Okay. He started selling pumps. He started exports. And he started other business too with the money what he has got. And he started savings. And so his life has completely changed actually. Because of, see, you are being paid for your efforts, really what you have to be paid for. So he went to the rich man now and he had asked the rich man. That day, you remember, you had given me a dried pumpkin. I have scolded you in my inside, actually. In my soul, I have scolded you a lot, actually. I didn't recognize what you meant on that day. I didn't recognize what you were trying to say me. But today I become wealthiest because of you only. If you have not given me the dried pumpkin on the day, I would not have these many pumpkins. I would not have done this, sold outside. I would not have earned money. All this, what I am today, has happened only because of you. See, if you are really capable of doing something, your efforts will be definitely recognized the way it has to be recognized, for sure. Actually, he didn't ask him that I am keeping a lot of efforts. You are a rich man. I will work for you. You give me more money than someone else is giving me. He didn't ask for the same. See, actually what has happened the other day, where no one has hired him, actually he is the first guy who is going to be hired to work for someone else. Everyone is coming and picking others, but not this guy. This has been intentionally, dramatically done by the richest man. The The rich man has told everyone, do not hire him for till afternoon. No one should hire him. Okay. So in his absence, he has told everyone. Okay. And no one has hired him for the same reason. So intentionally, so he has recognized the other guy and he wanted to give him a chance where he can grow in his life better than what he is today. Your efforts will be recognized for sure if you are really good. You are not required to blame someone. You are not required to ask someone. You will be automatically recognized for sure. So this is what, when you are good, it will be recognized for sure. When your views are good, your perception is good, your attitude is good. You will be recognized like this, if not by humans, definitely by God, if you believe in. Okay, so this is what a life is all about. Now, working as an employee under someone, he has replied, you are doing best. Okay, so everyone is giving you the same what they have. After you work for hours, hour morning to evening, you are exceeding their expectations. Still, they are not giving you something more than what you are expecting. They are giving you something. Your survival is as usual going on. You are also being satisfied. But this is not where you have to think about. You have to think next level. You should not continuously work under someone. You should have to be independent. You have to be a business owner. That's why I have given you a dried pumpkin. Now you had become business owner. Your life has now, it is better than what it was before. You work for a few days, that is okay. But one day you have to think about being your own owner. You must be working as an employee under some boss, but one day you have to become the boss. That is what you have to think about. Otherwise, your life will be where it is, but still you will have a desire of that, but you are not working towards your desire. Okay. So there are multiple things in this story. You will be definitely recognized if you're going to keep your efforts for sure. If you're good, if you're producing best results, definitely you'll be recognized. And also, it's not that you have to work for your lifetime under someone. You have to become a business owner one day, whatever the business is. An employee is employee always, who will never be recognized for sure. You're not required to be depressed of being not recognized by someone. It will never happen for an employee for sure. Okay, so if you really have such talent, definitely opportunities come to your feet. Okay, so those who are not being really recognized, meaning that you are not keeping the real efforts, what you have to keep. That is the problem with you only, not with the organizations. This is how you have to think about it.